excited to get into this because we have an incredible guest in studio. This track I came across not too long ago when he sent it to me. It comes off his 2017 mixtape, and it's so good. And I'm not going to play it for you right now because I like building a little bit of anticipation, but we have Slam Eazzy in the building.
How are you doing
today on a Tuesday? It was so hot in the city.
It was so hot.
Did you survive? Are you feeling all right?
I'm feeling great.
You feeling good?
Yeah.
Even better that you're here?
Yeah, it's kind of cool. Temperatures are good here, so I'm thinking.
Even in winter, believe me, the temperature is so cold. I don't understand who fixes the freaking air conditioner, but we're grateful for it in summer, of course. Slam Eazzy is in our midst. On Indie is the new major for today. Like I said, one of these tracks I'm going to be playing for you in just a little bit. But before we get there, let's get to know the man behind the music, right? 23 years old, grew up in Gauteng, and I want to know more about his childhood. I want to know about his journey into music as well. You say that you're part of a seventh wave of hip-hop. Can you explain that to me?
Seventh wave is actually a stable. It's like an independent stable.
Okay.
Label. So it's a Tembisa-based label, which is those guys. I recently just met those guys. I think this was late last year.
Mm-hmm.
So I recorded the song Games.
Mm-hmm.
So I recorded and the other joint I did with them, Go Hard.
Okay.
So where it all started?
Take me back.
It's been a while.
It hasn't been that long. Come on. Take me back
to your
childhood home where you listen to music. Do you listen to the radio? Did you buy some CDs?
A lot, actually. I grew up in a house whereby my father used to play. He loves music. So
mm-hmm.
what he used to do was just play records. Maybe he's outside doing the garden or
mm-hmm.
something like that. Put out speakers and just blast and make a noise and be doing whatever he's doing, listening to some music.
Absolutely, so with that soundtrack going.
Exactly. So I'm thinking that around that time, being around that environment and getting used to, okay, recently this is what's happening. 6 o'clock in the morning, he's already up doing
Yo,
his thing outside.
Pops didn't care about anybody's sleep. He was just blasting the music.
Township, so you can imagine those vibes. So I think that's where it all started out. I started listening to getting exposed to a lot of music. Then, obviously, some Kwaito.
Mm.
There was Kwaito time around that time. He was listening to radio, so what I would do is a song is playing on the radio, so I don't have these devices, right? I don't have the song on me, so I can't play it when I want to listen to it. The only time I can listen to a song is when it's playing on radio. So I'd be there with my book to just writing these lyrics down. Eminem is saying this, okay, so he said this time. The next time I listen, this is where I ended off, so I need to write this. That's how I used to do it.
Because you can't rewind.
Exactly.
You have to just keep
going.
So
that's how I actually kind of learned how to write.
Okay, and then when the song played again, you would now sing along, rap along, whatever
exactly.
it may be.
And that felt, it was a feeling of accomplishment.
Mm.
That word for word feeling that he's saying this and I'm saying this,
yeah.
that with him. It was really, I think that's when it all started out. Went on, grew up in it, started writing my own music. On the same, Eminem is saying this, I'm writing something else.
Mm.
I'm trying to find a way, what am I going to say? He's saying that way, I have to find my own way of expressing myself.
So that's about finding your voice, right? So
yes.
What exactly was the content of what you were writing about? Was it heartbreak? I mean, how old were you? Had you experienced life by then?
At the time, I think I was just doing it for fun. I just enjoyed that thing that, okay, music, I can listen to myself playing, like, because I used to, I got a phone, those old Nokia phones.
Yes, yes.
Started recording myself with that. Just listen to myself, how it sounded.
Mm.
And it was just beautiful. I loved it. In terms of content, I was pretty young. I think still in primary,
yeah.
like grade 7 or something like that. So it was really not too much thought into it.
Mm.
I was just looking for a rhyme. Anything that rhymed, I'd just go
you
and
went
just,
with it.
As long as it sounded nice.
The cat on the mat.
Exactly. That's it right there.
That's as far as my rapping career goes. Honestly, that's as far as I go. So did you ever come across a moment, because now you're 23, right? That was in primary school where you decided this is for me and this is the path in the career that I'm taking.
Yeah, when I grew in this, because I started now writing my own music, started downloading instrumentals online. Now I'm enjoying this. I get to actually come up with a song. I have to come up with a hook and something that, you know, so when to those small studios, bedroom studios with my guys, recording with those earphones. Like, it was just, that's where it all started. Then we started recording those and started listening to that. I'm like, okay, I'm going somewhere with this and I'm enjoying it. I'm loving it. Playing it for people, they're loving it. It's something that I can actually do. And I started growing into it, started exploring, trying to find out studios. Where can I book studios? Where can I do this? Where can I do that? Then I started learning and started appreciating this and seeing how people were responding to the stuff I was doing at that time. That told me that I can actually make something.
So that validation,
I was enjoying it, self-expression. And now you think that right now I'm actually, it's making sense. Whatever that I'm doing now, I'm actually putting in some thought into it, you know.
It's not something you stumbled into.
It's no longer just about the rhyme.
For sure.
Like, it has to make sense. Yeah. Now. People should relate to that.
Well, Slam Eazzy is in studio with me. Going to keep him here all the way till 9 o'clock. It's going to be a good one because just before 9, I'm going to play his track called Games. You want to stick around for this one, okay? It's hashtag Run This Town.
Vertex Events and Channel O present the blockbuster event of the season, the Movie Music Festival, with lit performances by AKA Questa, Ricky Rick, Nasty C, Black Motion, Shimza, OK Maloon Cool Cat, Twins on Decks, Frank Casino, DeCapo, DJ Sandiso, The Josh, Durban Gogo, and many more. The Movie Music Festival, 1 December at Monte Casino from midday until 11. Pledge your allegiance at CompuTicket from 150. Presented by Vertex Events in association with Channel O.
All this week, catch $0 given competition with Sean.